Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ, when we shower favor onto the human being, أَعْرَضْ, that the human being ignores it, deliberately ignores it. The suggestion here is that when human beings are given lots of gifts by Allah, human beings start becoming deluded into thinking somehow they deserve them, or they are entitled to them, or this is because of their own doing, or their own accomplishments, or their own capability. So they completely ignore the fact that these are favors. They actually start thinking they own them, or they're entitled to them in one way or the other. وَنَأَى بِجَانِبِهِ, and he turns away to his side. In other words, this is kind of a, let me give you an English translation, an American English translation of نَأَى بِجَانِبِهِ. That's نَأَى بِجَانِبِهِ. When somebody says Allah has given you a lot of favor, that's literally captured in language. So he huffs and puffs about the things that Allah has given and dismisses the idea that this is somehow a divine gift. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ, and when harm touches him, كَانَ يَأُوسَ, he becomes altogether depressed, full of sadness. Allah has done this to me. Why am I being put through this? What did I do to deserve this? When good happens, I deserved it. And it was my doing. But when bad happens, it wasn't my doing, it's Allah's doing. Allah did this to me. كَانَ يَأُوسَ, this twisted mind of his. What's really remarkable about this ayah is actually a lesson in adab, a lesson in etiquette, in how we not only think about Allah, but even how we talk about Allah. The way a person speaks is a manifestation of how they think. So when favor is mentioned, Allah says, وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ, this is a past tense, أَنْعَمْنَا, who's the doer? نَحْنُ, it's Allah, we shower him. But when it says, وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ, when favor is mentioned, then the doer, the subject of the verb, is Allah, when we shower him with favor. When harm hits him, Allah says, Massa, huwa massa, and the outside doer, the fa'il, is asharru. In other words, Allah did not associate himself with harm. So Allah did not say, when we make harm touch him, or we afflict him with harm. He didn't do that. He didn't associate harm to himself. And this is actually teaching us something, a very deep concept in our religion, about harm and benefit in this world. At the end of the day, what's our belief? Everything is from Allah. When someone gets sick, it's from Allah. When someone gets better, it's from Allah. That's our belief. Nothing happens except for the will of Allah. But that doesn't mean that we get to talk about it like that. Even though that's the reality, there's supposed to be a certain level of respect. Why is that? And you have to, if it's truth, it's truth. You should just be able to say it. Why code it with formality? This is also an important lesson. Allah teaches us in a way that is suitable for all human beings. You see, a mature student, a mature believer, they know that when good happens, there's good in it. And when that bad happens, there's also good in it. And all of it is a test. This is a mature believer. But anyone short of being mature, anyone that's not that mature in their faith, then when bad happens and you say it's from Allah, how did they think of it? Literally as Allah did something bad, and He means something bad by it. Like they cannot process anything more mature than that, right? So Allah reveals language that for someone who's deeply going to reflect will also understand, but somebody who just looks at it on the surface level can still appreciate and not get the wrong conclusion. Harm touched him. Allah did not say when harm, Allah harmed him. Allah didn't say it like that. Because for the immature, just listening to that, he'd just get messed up. And He's actually correcting the immature by saying, وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرْ كَانَ يَوْسَ. When harm touches him, he becomes entirely depressed. He becomes overwhelmed. يَأُوس, actually, فَعُول, this is from يَأِس, is mubalagha, extremely depressed. You know, there are some people who are used to success. They're used to just getting 100, they're used to winning every race, they're used to winning every game, they're used to being number one at everything, you know. They're used to getting their parents to listen to everything they say, etc., etc. Then one time they don't get their way. What happens to those kinds of people? Those are the kinds of people in life that have a really hard time dealing with failure, or dealing with loss, or dealing with a challenge. People that take the hits all the time, like the fourth kid or fifth kid or something in a family, it's all good. Or the youngest one, you know, youngest kids, like, you know, I'm afraid for my youngest one because, you know, she can get away with pretty much anything. You know, because at the time, by the time you get to the youngest age, then, you know, for some reason the policing of your parents just, I don't know where it goes. Like I tell my mother and father that about my youngest sister. They were tough on us, but my youngest sister gets away with that. And I'm like, Mom, what happened? This was not policy with us. She's so little. She's not little. What happens with people, they get spoiled. Favors can spoil someone. And so when a little bit is taken away, they become entirely depressed. Now this lesson that Allah teaches us about favor, harm touching you, all of us in this dunya have been given a limited number of ni'mah and a limited number of shar. On the one hand, Allah has decided what our rizq is going to be. Our rizq, our provision includes our money, but it also includes our friends. Our family is our rizq. Our knowledge is our rizq. People who teach us is our rizq. The people who learn from us are our rizq. Our children are our rizq. Every good you have in your life is basically your rizq. You don't have an unlimited amount of this stuff. Where do you get the unlimited stuff? You get that in Jannah. Here, there's a limited supply of what you're going to get. It's written for you. Then on top of that, there's a limited number of challenges that you're going to face in this life. Allah is not going to give you any more than or any less than what He's written for you. That's it. It's declared, this is what your lot in life is. Now if you internalize that, that your challenges and your opportunities are not the same as my challenges and my opportunities. They're not the same. And sometimes Allah opens a door of opportunity, but you refuse to walk through it. You could have reaped a lot of reward from it, but you chose to not walk through it. And then you end up suffering. And then you end up blaming Allah instead.